Hi dear students, welcome to Source Science class. In today's class, we'll be continuing the second lesson in Source Science, that is Natural Calamities. The previous class, we have studied about the formation of earthquake and the volcanic eruptions. In today's class, we'll be studying about floods and droughts. Floods and droughts are very common and frequent natural calamities which occur in India. Now, we'll be studying about floods first. Floods occur when there is a major overflow of water from river banks and surrounding areas. So mainly the floods occur due to the overflow of water from the water bodies such as seas, river, ocean, lakes, etc. So now we'll be studying what are the major reasons for these floods. Floods can be happen due to the heavy rainfall, cloudburst, rapid melting of snow in mountains, landslides and breaking of river embankments. So these are the major reasons for flood which happens in India. What are the major reasons? Due to the heavy rainfall, cloudburst, rapid melting of snow in mountains and landslides are the major four reasons which cause floods in India. Now we'll be studying what are the major precautions that we should practice during the time of flood. During such situation, a few precautions needed to be followed. Till help arrives, it's important to switch off all electrical appliances and move to safer ground. This is the first and major precaution that we should practice when we are affected with flood. What is that? We should switch off all the electric appliances. As you all know, the electricity easily passes through the water. So what is first precaution? Till help arrives, it is important to switch off all the electric appliances and we should move to the safer ground. Now we'll be studying about one of the major flood which occurred on 16 and 17 of June 2013 in India. It is called Uttarakhand flood. On 16 and 17 of June 2013, a huge cloudburst and heavy rain caused landslides and massive floods in many districts in Uttarakhand. An Uttarakhand flood which happened on 2013 was considered as one of the major and severe flood which occurred in India. And we'll be studying what are the major reasons for the Uttarakhand flood. The cloudburst and heavy rainfall and the landslides are the major three reasons that caused Uttarakhand flood. The landslides, the massive landslides, heavy rainfall and the cloudburst are the major three reasons which caused huge damage to the Uttarakhand district. There also damaged the holy shrine of Kedarnath and affected thousands of pilgrims. So Kedarnath pilgrimage center is one of the famous pilgrimage center in India. And due to this Uttarakhand flood, this Kedarnath shrine, holy shrine, was severely damaged, and many around 1,000 of people were died and seriously affected with the Uttarakhand flood on 16 and 17 June 2013. Now we'll be studying about the second natural calamity. Another natural calamity is called droughts. In the previous class, the first lesson of Source Science, we have already studied about the drought, the definition of drought. Shortage of water in an area due to the less or no rainfall is called drought. So that is the definition, that is the meaning of the term drought. What is that? Shortage of water in area due to the less or no rainfall is called drought. An area of land which is not getting rainfall for a long period of time, which that causes drought to the land. Drought occurs due to the absence of rainfall for months, even years, and results in crop failure, starvation and death. So this is the major negative result of drought. What is that? It caused crop failure. It can also be the reason for starvation and death to animals and human beings. Now we'll be studying which are the major drought prone areas in India. In India, the major drought prone region are southern and eastern Maharashtra, northern Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Gujarat and Rajasthan. These are the major drought prone areas in India. Which are those? Maharashtra, North Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Gujarat and Rajasthan. Okay, now we'll be studying how we can avoid drought from our places. Planting trees, water harvesting system and growing drought resistant crops like millets and maize can help to avoid drought. So these are the major practices that we should practice to avoid drought from our land. What is that? We should plant trees, we should plant and make water harvesting system in our places, and we should also plant drought resistant crops like millet and maize. So these are the major two drought resistant crops which can survive in the drought prone areas. So these are the major practices we should practice to avoid droughts from our land. These are the notes from the chapter. The seventh question: what are the major causes of floods? The answer: floods occur when there is a major overflow of water over river banks and surrounding areas. Floods can be happen due to the heavy rainfall, cloudbursts, rapid melting of snow in mountains, landslides, etc. So by that we have come to the end of the chapter 2. In this chapter we have studied about the formation of earthquake, and we have studied about the different types of volcanic eruption. In today we have studied about the another two natural calamities called floods and drought, and we have studied what are the major precautions that we should practice to avoid these natural calamities. So write down these notes in your notebook and read the textbook many times. By that you will be thorough with the main point from the chapter. Okay, so we'll be seeing next class. Thank you.